Good morning.
Good morning.
Did you expect me to speak sooner? Were you waiting to hear words? Were you wondering why I was smiling and not saying anything? I just wanted to get a closer, better look at all of you. It fills my heart with joy to be here this morning at Villan Boys School amidst 36 schools, over 300 children, participant children from these 36 schools, teachers, principals, and of course our own Villan Boys School boys. My favorite people in the world are children. It is because each time I interact or meet children, I find in their eyes and in their spirit a life that most grown-ups seem to have left behind. Your spirit of curiosity, your enthusiasm, your empathy strengthen me. And there is so much that is happening in this world around us that needs active voices, your participation. But through my participation and my understanding of what's happening, and every time I feel bewildered or scared or overwhelmed by the enormity of many of our issues, I look at children and I feel better. I want to address a few things here this morning, but I really hope that you will participate with what I'm saying to you. I don't want my words to be heard. I hope that my words can be felt. So, can we start with closing our eyes? Ask yourself, who am I? Is the first thought that came to your mind your name? Nod, keep the eyes shut, don't cheat. Was the first thought that came to your mind your name? Yes. Okay, somebody had a different thought. I'd like to hear what that one was a little later. Who am I? Did your nation, the name of your nation come into mind when you asked yourself that question? I am an Indian. Or I am British. It did? Yes? No? No. A majority say no. I can't hear you.
No.
So what? Ask yourself the question again. Who am I? Ask yourself again. You know, it's like an onion peel. You keep peeling away, you keep asking yourself that question, and you will discover that all that you state, which is considered the obvious, will disappear. And eventually, you will discover yourself saying, I am. And that's a very powerful understanding, that you are. Now, when we look at nature, you can open your eyes, Katie. When we look to nature, we look to the elephant, this powerful symbol of Villan Boys School. Or we look at a tree, or the birds, or any entity in the environment. Each entity is performing a service. Their existence facilitates life itself. Think about it. Those migratory birds that arrive in India all the way from Siberia, do they need passports? Do they have national identities? I can't hear you guys, talk to me. Do they need to clear immigration? Go through metal detectors? They fly. They cross oceans. They battle winds. They deal with all kinds of circumstances. And they arrive only to settle for a little while. And then they fly again. If we think about just this one thing, we might help ourselves in understanding the idea of identity. We human beings have collectively managed to tell ourselves over centuries that we are special. Yes, we are. But we are not special in a way that makes us separate from nature. We were born in nature. We are a part of nature, not apart from nature. So just like those migratory birds and every living entity in nature, remember that you belong, you are connected, and that every function you perform in life can facilitate life itself. Have you ever thought about this? Because I think about it a lot. Even in destruction in nature, there's creation. Can one of you stand up and give me an example of that? Please?
When an egg hatches, something is born out of it.
An egg hatches, so the shell is destroyed, it cracks. Something beautiful and alive emerges from it, and life is born. Wonderful example.